In the previous lesson, we learned how to insert several dimensions. However, depending on the size of our drawing and our own preferences, we may need to modify the dimension style. For example, in the current drawing, as you can see, the dimensions do not appear correctly. In fact, I have to zoom in a lot to even see if there really are dimensions. So, in this case, I definitely need to change the way the dimensions appear. To modify the dimension styles, I need to open the Dimension Style Manager window. I can open this window if I expand either the Format menu or the Dimension menu. Alternatively, I can expand the Annotation panel of the Home ribbon and click on the Dimension Style icon. Once I click on it, the window with all the available dimension styles appears. Since in this drawing the AutoCAD ISO template was selected, there is also the ISO 25 dimension style. Before I proceed to change anything, I should mention that the style that was used in this drawing is the standard style. So I will select the standard style and click on the Modify button. A new window opens with several tabs that contain all the available modification options. Firstly, I will open the Primary Units tab to change the precision of the dimensions to zero decimal places. So I will open the list of the Linear Dimensions Precision field and select the first option. Notice that the preview on the right changed accordingly. Similarly, I can change the precision of the angular dimensions from the list in the Angular Dimension section. I will set the number of decimal places to 1 for angles. Next, to adjust the text size, I will move to the Text tab and change the value in the Text Height field to 5. From the Text Appearance section, I can change the way the text appears. I will click on the text color list and apply the cyan color to the text. Right now, from the fill color text, I can set a color for the background. Notice how the preview changes when I select a color for the background. However, in this example, I will reopen the list and select the None option to remove the background color again. By activating the checkbox of Draw Frame Around Text option, an outline is created around the numbers. I will deactivate this option again and move to the Text Placement options. Vertically, we usually select either the Centered option or the Above option. In this case, I will select the Centered option so the numbers will appear in the center of the dimension line. I am also given quite a few options about the horizontal text placement, but in the end, the centered option is what is mostly used. The View Direction field controls the direction of the text, and in my case, I do not need to change the default option. An important field is the Offset from the Dimension Line field. The value in this field defines the gap between the text and the dimension line. As you can see, the current value is 0.09. If we look at the preview, the dimension lines are too close to the numbers. To get a clearer picture of what this number represents, I will change the offset value to 5. Now, if you look at the preview again, notice that there is a big difference in how the dimension lines appear. The value I set is a bit exaggerated relatively to the size of the numbers, but as I mentioned earlier, I wanted to give you a clearer picture of what this offset value represents. So I will change this value again to 1.5. Finally, I can align the text with the dimension line. To understand what changes, I suggest that you look at the vertical and the align dimensions in the preview. Even though I have finished with the changes I wanted to make concerning the way the text appears, it seems that the arrows have disappeared. I will go to the Symbols and Arrows tab and notice that the arrow size is 0.18, which is way smaller than the size of the numbers, which was set to 5, and that's why they aren't visible in the preview. So, first and foremost, I will change the arrow size to a number close to the text size. In this example, I will set this value to 4.5, and notice how the arrows reappear in the preview. From the drop-down lists above the arrow size field, I can change the arrowhead type of dimension lines. At the moment, I will select the dot type. Next, I can define how the center marks will appear. If I check none, then no center mark appears in the circle. By activating the mark option, a center mark appears, but again, compared to the text and arrows, it's too small to be clearly visible. So I will type the number 2 in the value field next to the mark option, and notice how it appears in the preview. By selecting the line option, lines appear in the center of the circle. In this example, I will select the none option and move on to the arc length symbol options to define how the arc symbol will appear. Since there is no arc length dimension in the preview, I will explain the three options using an image. If I select the first option, the symbol will appear before the number. If I select the second option, the symbol will appear above the number. And if I select none, then the arc symbol will not appear at all. In this example, I will select the above dimension text option. Last but not least, I will modify the dimension and the extension lines. To do that, I will activate the first tab. The first section has to do with the dimension lines, while the second with the extension lines. In the first section, I will change the color of the dimension lines to cyan. I can also change the line type as well as the line weight if needed. In this example, though, I will not change those options. Extend Beyond Ticks becomes available if you select the architectural, the oblique, or the integral arrow type. It defines the distance of the dimensions line extension beyond the extension lines as shown in the image. The value of baseline spacing sets the spacing between the dimension lines of baseline dimensions. Since I set the text size to 4, I will change the baseline spacing to 12. Moving on, if I select to suppress the dimension lines by activating the checkboxes Dimension Line 1 and Dimension Line 2, as you can see in the preview, they disappear completely. I will not suppress the dimension lines since this is not what I want to do, and I will move on to the extension lines options. The first option defines the color of the extension lines, which I will also change to cyan. Just like in dimension lines, I can also change the line type as well as the line weight if needed. Furthermore, I can suppress the extension lines if I do not wish them to appear. In case I do not suppress them, I can specify the length of the extension beyond the dimension lines and the gap between the extension lines and the points that define the dimension. In this example, I will set the value in the Extend Beyond Dimension Lines field to 5, and in the Offset from Origin field, I will set the value to 1. If I wish them to have a fixed length, I can activate the checkbox of the Fixed Length Extension Lines option. Once I am satisfied with the result, I will click OK to exit the Modify Dimension Style window, and I will also close the Dimension Style Manager window. Notice how different the dimensions appear, and most importantly, how clearer we can see them compared to previously. Now the first shape is the section of a pipe corner, and the dimension in the middle represents the diameter. However, since in this particular view of the pipe there is no circle or arc, the aligned dimension was used to display the distance of the diameter. In case I want to add the symbol of the diameter before the number of the distance, I will double-click on it. Once I double-click on it, the text editor ribbon appears and I can edit the text. So from the Insert panel and the Symbols drop-down, I will select the diameter symbol. Then I will click on Close Text Editor and repeat the procedure for the other two aligned dimensions that represent diameters. Now I will inspect the second shape. Notice that the baseline dimensions are still on one another, even though I have already increased the baseline spacing significantly. Unfortunately, I have to delete the baseline dimensions and reinsert them in order to be placed with the new distance I specified earlier. So I will select those dimensions and delete them. Then I will open the dimension menu and select the baseline option. I will click on the left exit line of the linear dimension that remained, and then I will click on the end points to insert the baseline dimensions. Once I'm done, I will press Escape to exit the command.